Hey everybody, welcome back to Let's Play The Binding of Isaac. Obviously, we're dealing with the Wrath of the Lamb here, and I am going to play as Judas. I think he is the last character that we have to beat the game with. And it feels weird starting the game with a starting item after playing as Eve for so long, and then of course playing as Samson, the past run, and you know, Blue Baby before that. Hey, that is really convenient, actually, getting a Spirit Heart right on the first room is obviously going to go a long way towards making sure Judas survives that really difficult starting part of the game. I mean, Judas is like an infant, right? You know, like if you're a normal infant, an average infant in the West, at least, you know, those first few months of life are really like the most dangerous part of your life until you become an elderly individual, like a truly elderly individual. You know, it's very easy for a 10-year-old to survive, but for a 10-day-old, you know, just farting, you have the potential to, like, knock your own brains out of your skull. Judas is like that. He's like a typical Western infant where, you know, you have to nurture him through the first few floors. And then after that, he becomes a monster and, you know, you have to send him to juvie or military school or something. But, you know, until then, let's just enjoy the time we have where we are the protector, making sure that our... Ah! What a terrible dodge. Making sure that our beautiful baby boy survives long enough to kill his own mother. So, we have tons of keys already. I mean, two is not necessarily a ton. Unless... Oh my god, that dodging, man. Unless, you know, I guess each key weighed like half of a ton. But in any case, on the first floor, two is a lot. Because it means we can go to the treasure room, pick up the odd mushroom, which is a damage upgrade, as well as a health upgrade, apparently. Although... my head now is making it a little bit difficult for me to walk through doors. I'm just going back up here to get a little bit of extra health before we move onwards. A very little bit of extra health. I thought that was going to be a full heart. But anyway, hey, that's a good upgrade. Get that health upgrade, get the damage upgrade, so we've nullified some of Judas's starting problems. I guess damage isn't a huge deal for him, but more damage is always a good thing. We'll kill that guy in like two hits. It's like having a rage permanently on like 50% level. We should kill basically all these enemies. I kind of, like, my Isaac Sixth Sense is starting to work pretty strongly now that it played, like, five episodes today. Or recorded five episodes today, anyway. I can just be like, yeah, I'm pretty sure we're gonna kill this enemy in exactly three hits. I still want to do a little bit more exploring on this floor, but we'll go fight the boss right away, because why not? Pop Book of Belial, this should be an easy, easy fight. Is this Gemini, or is this... this is Gemini, okay, not Little Steven. So you know what, I'm gonna try... oh, that was bad. I'm gonna try to take out the little version first. Oh, it doesn't make a difference on this one. Oh my god, I may actually die. What is up with this champion, man? I was gonna say I'm gonna try to take out the little one first so we could get Big Steven instead of Little Steven, but it actually makes no difference for us at all. Because we will probably get some kind of health upgrade here. Was this Curse of the Labyrinth? Did I miss something? I guess it is. We have double boss fights here. Which is a shame. I don't really want to deal with that. In fact, I would rather just get some extra hearts somewhere, please. Drop some hearts, little Gemini, when you die. I would greatly appreciate it. And don't explode in a hail of bullets. That's why I'm being super careful. Awesome, okay. A little bit of extra health. Wire coat hanger. If I'd known that, I probably wouldn't have used... oh, awesome, we're gonna get a spirit out here. I probably wouldn't have used Book of Belial. I might have saved it for the second boss. That's okay. You know, we're still doing terrible amounts of damage from Larry Jr.'s perspective. He's already half dead, or one half of him is already dead, I suppose I should say. So we'll just truck this out, assuming he will drop a spirit heart when he dies. We'll be in a good position health-wise. Hopefully we'll get a health upgrade as well. No, instead we will get... okay, first things first, this. This. Okay, that gives us a lot of stuff here. Let's talk about this very quickly. What's this pill? Range down. Not a huge problem. Justice is good. Don't really need it right now, though. Fish head. This is new. Now let's see what Satan's got for us. Kinda hoping it would be Krampus. I don't really want to shell out for either of those, unfortunately. Okay, we'll pick that up, and then we'll continue exploring. Now that we have some bombs, and in fact we will have another bomb in a second, if I use this Justice card, we can maybe find the secret room, we can maybe get a little bit more money, and then we can maybe go to the shop on the first floor, which would be awesome. That, of course, will give us another key as well when we use that Justice card. And Book of Belial is ready. Oh, there's another treasure room! Man, I am not on the ball right now. So much for my Isaac Sixth Sense. I was like... man, maybe we'll just go down to the next floor. Thank God I reneged on that decision. So we will absolutely pick up whatever we got in here. That's a new item as well, I think. Celtic Cross, you feel blessed. No idea. But, you know, being blessed is never a bad thing. Perhaps we will come across something that will indicate what the heck this item does. Since we are dealing with Curse of the Labyrinth, I will probably... Yeah, that's worth it. I will probably not look for the secret room, because I only have one bomb left, but I may still be able to look for the shop. And as far as I'm concerned, damage, health, we're doing fine on basically all fronts right now. Spacebar item's good. We could truck through the next few floors very, very quickly, I think. Which is obviously, always an added bonus. It's gonna be super easy. There is our shop. We got a couple of bombs here that we will not be able to access. Celtic Cross makes me look pretty cool, but I'm kind of confused as to its effects. Hopefully, maybe, I'll take a look at the wiki after this game. He said and then promptly didn't. See what the heck this does, because right now, it may have a subtle effect. Maybe it causes more tinted hearts or spirit hearts to drop, in which case that's awesome. Who knows? For now, we'll just enjoy the fact that we're living in a fairly good area right now. There's another damage upgrade for us, another bomb, so that costs us literally nothing to get that damage upgrade, and we are rolling with respect to damage right now. Just a little bit more money would make it possible for me to visit the shop. I should one-shot, yeah, one-shotting the flies. Feels good, man. So we'll very quickly shoot all this poop. I think damage makes poop faster to shoot, which is kind of weird. Alas, nothing there. We could use Justice. Maybe Justice would drop a nickel. Nope, he indeed dropped only a cent. And that, losing that heart was kind of a waste, but again, hopefully that's the kind of thing that doesn't come back to haunt me. For now, Basement XL has been very, very good to me. We'll come down here. I think there's more poop. Yeah, this is the room I was thinking of. We'll shoot all this poop. Maybe we'll get lucky. And one of these will drop a nickel, but if not, suppose we'll just make our way down to the boss room and proceed from there. Alright. In spite of the fact that we can't visit the shop here, good floor. Very, very good floor. 12 cents, 3 bombs, 2 keys, lots of damage upgrades, lots of health upgrades. Well, not lots of health upgrades, but we got a good assortment of spirit hearts right now. Was there another poop in this room that I missed? I'm trying to be thorough, you never know, just in case. Okay, that's fine. Smiley faces abound. Feeling pretty solid right now. We got a good start. First two floors have been good to me. Which is crazy. Oh, man, we're gonna fight the boss right away. Why not? We're already here. Again, no idea what the fish head does, but that is another thing that I will say that I'm gonna look up in the wiki and then will not look up in the wiki. We're gonna be dealing with Pestilence on this floor. Might as well pop the Book of Belial. Even though Pestilence is a very, very easy boss. You know what would be fantastic right now? Rage. I already have insane starting base damage. Getting Rage on top of that would turn me into a basically unbelievable killing machine. Kinda hoping for a deal with the devil. That's alright though. Pick up our rightfully earned spirit heart and our cube of meat, and then proceed to explore the rest of the floor, knowing that we are basically unkillable because we've already taken out the boss. Maybe that was a little bit too cocky. Oftentimes the boss is easier than the rooms that precede it. For now. Single fistula room is not a bad room for us at all. We got enough keys to make the shop and the item room and the library and, possibly golden chests worthwhile. I'm in a good mood so far in this run. Normally in a Judas run, like, that first floor is so important. It's make or break. And there's our nickel, so we can easily go to the shop now and pick up whatever we want. That first floor is make or break. And maybe first few floors, because, if you don't get health upgrades, if you're still rolling on one heart by, the caves part two, you're probably going to find yourself in a bad situation sooner rather than later. But this way, I'm feeling pretty strong. We have Ball of Yarn. Daddy Long Legs. There's a foot hovering over me. I think if I get hit, maybe this foot will come down and do damage to whatever hit me. We got the candle. I mean, that's a great item, but is it worth more than the, Book of Belial right now? Probably. Let's pick it up. Could be fun. I would love to get 2 more cents and visit the, visit the shop again to pick up the spirit heart that I just abandoned. But it's not a deal breaker. We've explored basically everything we needed on this floor, I feel. Man, okay, Daddy Long Legs. Just went down and killed an enemy in this room. So, is it just me or is that awesome? Got Lucky Toe, that's a new one for me. Daddy Longlegs appears to occasionally come down with a foot. Every time. Or not every time, but a couple times per room. Maybe it takes a while to recharge, but otherwise, that's an incredible passive to have. Wow. So we have the tower. The tower will function, of course, as Anarchist Cookbook, basically. Thank you, Daddy Longlegs. It felt creepy just saying that, but we'll check out our mob trap room quickly. Why not? We're basically rolling with power right now. There's another... Getting so many new items. I'm not sure if I changed something when I beat the game as Samson and Eve. But in any case, guess I'm getting closer to that Platinum God achievement for getting all the items in the new expansion. That's still a distant dream, although I know a lot of people have accomplished it already. You know, cut me some slack. My Isaac aptitude is still a little lacking. You know what? We will pick up Lucky Toe's cool. Let's go with the counterfeit penny. I don't know. Maybe it's awesome. Maybe it's garbage. We'll see. And with three bombs, I'm very tempted to use two of the... but there's three possible locations for the secret room. I'm going to save my bombs for now. I'm happy with the candle and the Daddy Longlegs and the counterfeit penny, whatever that does, and, you know, the damage upgrades I've received. By and large, this has been an interesting and unusual run so far. And I'm also very powerful, and I appreciate that. Daddy Longlegs doesn't seem super strong. Like, I don't think it does that much damage to things it comes down on, but still, man, that level of crowd control. Can't buy that in the store. I mean, literally, I don't think you can buy Daddy Longlegs in the shop. Alright, Daddy Longlegs will take care of that there. He's already proved more useful than, like, a third level cube of meat. Here you go, he's doing a little bit of damage to Wrath. Can't complain about that. Where are you? Yeah, you just take him out. I'll just chill. So kick this back at him. No! No, no! That was scary. Drop some... Yeah, the fire took that guy out easily. Man, my damage is crazy right now. From multiple sources. I could have probably survived keeping Book of Belial. I think that would have been, like, a perfectly adequate choice as well. But, you know, we had the chance to check out this candle. It's an item I've used a few times, but I always enjoy using it because it makes it a little bit more exciting, don't you think? Daddy Longlegs kind of ran out of things to do there, but that's okay. I'm spoiled for choice when it comes to murdering my enemies right now. So there's our boss. Daddy Longlegs doing work. Much appreciated. Can't believe I took damage there. That was pretty shitty of me, but hey, we'll fight the boss right away. We're on Caves Part 2. It's gonna be Fistula, which means Daddy Longlegs should be doing some good work for me here. Yeah, you just take care of those... Oh, it's Bombfly Fistula anyway. Wow, that was quick. There's our health upgrade. Quickly talk to Satan, see what he's got for me. Rage for 2! Let's get dangerous. Like I said, Rage would be a great pickup right now. Now let's make it count. I really need more health upgrades probably now to make this work, but... If this gamble proves to be successful, I will be doing incredible amounts of damage. Like, I'm already one-shotting simple enemies. I think this is going to make bosses incredibly easy. And just hopefully I'm able to hold on to these spirit hearts. Two-shotting turrets right now, Daddy Longlegs doing similar things himself. I could use a speed upgrade, actually. I feel pretty slow. Hey, bring it on. Okay, don't... Daddy Longlegs, you're kind of actually fucking me up here. There we go. We got a pill. Let's take it. What's the worst that could happen? Balls of steel. That is one of the best things that could happen, actually. Either that or just a health up. Getting very lucky so far. I can't believe we haven't even been to the treasure room on this floor. I've got so much more to discover. Could potentially go to the shop. At this point, I would probably get rid of Candle for Book of Belial. Oh my god, it's another Balls of Steel pill. Yeah, I would probably get rid of the candle for Book of Belial, or sorry, Book of Revelations if I could buy it. That was terrible. I blame that entirely. Oh. Oh man, no, not again! I blame that entirely on my Daddy Longlegs buddy over here. That's okay, candle should make this easy. We can go to the boss room because I only have one red heart container. Could get something awesome in there. I did ask for a speed upgrade, so I can't complain too hard. Eh, it's only Monstro anyway. Obviously, fire and rage is going to make this pretty darn easy. Not to mention Daddy Longlegs. So we'll just let him do most of the work, I guess, and I'll hang back and just enjoy my nearly free speed upgrade. Got a key out of it as well. So there's a shop. Flying would be another nice item to pick up right now, but for now, I'm happy with what I got. That was super easy, and our treasure room item is... Speedballs! So extra damage, extra shot speed. Cool. Everything I've asked for is basically coming true. Maybe we'll get lucky. We'll find a Steam sale in the shop down here. Not always the most likely thing. That's a new item. I don't know what that is. Maybe we'll look for the secret room. And if I find the secret room, I will pick that up just to see what it does, really. Assuming the secret room, of course, has money in it. And the secret room does, and not enough. Not enough, unfortunately. So I guess we'll have to save that item that looks kind of like a jack-in-the-box for another day. Hopefully, you know, I really wanted it to be a passive, but even if it was an active... Ooh, man, that's the 15th cent, okay. Even if it's an active, that's okay. I'll discover what it does, and even if I don't use it, again, just add it to my collection. That's more items that I've received. It's worth the 15 cents. Are you noticing that... Looks like every time I pick up a penny, it actually picks up 2 pennies because of counterfeit penny? Is that what's going on here? Portable slot machine. Alright, good to know. Probably will never use that in the future. But knowing what it does, that's a bonus. So we'll head down to the next floor, which I'm hoping is the depths as opposed to utero, and you know, I don't know why, I just have a hunch that our second secret room is right on the left side of this one. So let's try that out. Okay, like I said, it was a hunch. If I had Ipecac, if I had Fetus in a Jar, I would take a crack at those, but I don't. And I am actually happy to not have those. This feels like a much more relaxing run so far. So we will just make our way down to the next floor. And, you know, hope that everything works out for the best. We've got good items. We just need more spirit hearts, basically. And if somehow we can get that, then crisis averted. I have a feeling we're going to, like, one-shot most of the later bosses we come to. Especially if I get more damage upgrades. Like, I don't even think... Did I get the pentagram already? I don't think so. That's a fairly common damage drop. I wish that the... Oh, man, that was close. I wish that the Daddy Longlegs actually destroyed rocks when it came down. That would be awesome. More spirit hearts, please. Alright, that's fine. I'll accept it. We got these douchebags right here, who should die. Yeah, very easily. I'm really impressed with my base damage right now. Daddy Longlegs, of course, doing what he does best. I'll come back for that penny later. Assuming I don't run into substantial health problems. Either in the game or in real life, I suppose. We got a mob trap room that we will, of course, visit as well. Daddy Longlegs having some trouble hitting these leapers. I don't blame you, man. I've been in that position, you know, hundreds of times before in my life. That was a very good shot with the fire. And we will fight the boss here. We might as well. It's going to be Gish. Gish has been showing up a lot more commonly lately, for whatever reason. Not that I'm complaining, because obviously having a guaranteed slow effect is awesome. And Gish is one of those bosses that is incredibly easy to fight as well. Especially when you have Rage, because, you know, I'm also, you know, gaining damage by killing the little Gish that it shoots out. And also its creep doesn't do damage. I think Gish needs a buff. There's our little Gish. So we have even more hurting power now. Still, I may remind you, I have not visited the treasure room or the shop on this floor. Maybe it's every room where we get a penny, we also, or where we get any money, we also get an extra cent at the end of it. I don't know. Counterfeit penny is still kind of confusing me. But, can't complain so far, you know, giving me that extra money that may come in handy. Fire is good against zombies, so is Daddy Longlegs. And that was super easy. These are my favorite kind of Isaac runs, because they're runs where, you know, you're not insanely overpowered. Like, you do well, but you're not insanely overpowered. The reason you do well, though, is because of, like, these unusual item combinations that you pick up. It's not just, like, a standard brimstone flying run. Not that there's anything wrong with that, you know, those runs have their place from time to time, as you've seen me do, you know, probably 20 times. But I just like these runs where it mixes it up a little bit more. Let's check on our shop briefly. I don't really want anything in here, so we can safely ignore that from now on. 9 bombs, so I don't feel like that was a substantial waste. I also have the tower card. I could use that to find a secret room or something. But, you know, I usually dislike using that card because I hurt myself a lot. Don't really want to go to that demon judgment when I can't replenish my hearts. Very easy. Definitely worth a bomb to get a key in a chest. I think... Ooh, that's the burnt penny. I don't know what this one does, but I think I've had it before. Whatever, let's stick with it. Burnt equals I kind of figured I was screwed there. But hey! I got hit. And then I got this shield of protection. I wonder if that's from Celtic Cross. If so, that's really good. Telepills has taken me far away from where I wanted to be. But it's worth it. I should always go to the item room before I use telepills. I gotta program that into my brain. Because I could have just, like, seriously missed out there by, of course, going to, getting telepills, going to the I Am Arrow room, and then never being able to get sweet toothpicks, you know? I mean, it's not the best item in the game, but it's alright. Continue holding the tower card, I suppose. Daddy Longlegs making sure nobody gets on my case. If that's what Celtic Cross does, that is actually really, really useful, and will be insanely useful once we get to the womb. Because it'll protect us from those, like, those periods where I take a lot of damage, which is just like I get trapped in a corner with something, and then it's like, oh god, oh god, oh god, oh god. So I think with Burnt Penny, I'm going to try to shoot as much fire as I possibly can. My guess is that it probably makes pennies fall from fires more frequently. Not sure how many more fires we're going to come across in this game, but, you know, I'm trying the trinkets out, trying to figure it out for myself. So far, so good. And on this floor, I think we're basically done. Could look for the secret room very quickly. Let's check just under the shop. I'm willing to waste one bomb. Actually, let's use the tower card. That didn't really work. And in fact hurt us, but it did find the secret room. Where we ended up fighting Greed! Oh, this emotional roller coaster, I can't deal with it. Well, anyway. We pick up pennies, it also gives us bombs as a assortment with Burnt Penny. That's a nice pickup. Kinda wasted a spirit heart there, but I got enough money to make the shop on the next floor worthwhile, so I can't complain too much. Picked up a few extra bombs as a result of it as well. But really need to run into like a Book of Revelations or a relic or something to give me the peace of mind that I need here. I imagine this room is probably a bad one for Daddy Longlegs. No, actually, it worked out totally fine. I was thinking that it would do the same thing that, like, the mulligan flies do, which is attack the invulnerable. Come on. Daddy Longlegs, save me! This is a dick room. Especially since those guys do one full heart each. But anyway, we'll take this pill. Speed down. That's alright, I got a lot of speed upgrades. That really is a shitty room, though. I'm not sore about it, I'm just saying. I don't think I can get that key. Maybe I can nudge past it? No, not really. Well, just toss our candle in here. Should be enough to do that. There's our shop. We got a compass. Yep, that's definitely worth it. Would love to get 3 more cents to buy that extra spirit heart as well. Because I'm running a little bit low. Alright, well, I didn't want to waste a key to do that. But I did. So we will move onwards here. I think that is that a boss room? If that is a boss room, that is great for us. Health upgrade would obviously be insanely good. Hate the shit out of this room, as you guys have heard me say 1,000 times before. I think this Judas build is like strongly... It's incredibly strong. Against single targets. Against multiple targets, still pretty damn strong, but things become a little bit more hairy. I've got to have better candle shooting. But for now, you know, things going pretty well, if unusually. Tons of bombs. Range plus tiers, why not? Probably not going to end up fighting anything too crazy in here. Alright, that was easy enough. What do we got now? Peep! Alright, that's kind of a tough boss to be fighting. In just a standard room like this, but, you know, Daddy Longlegs, candle. I think this has been well worth it. We'll get another bomb drop for, you know, basically no reason. Feel a sneeze coming on, but I'm gonna hold it in. I'm gonna persevere through Isaac. I could afford to open that golden chest, actually. And that is something that I may consider, depending on how these next few rooms go. A little bit of extra money. Remember, I could buy another spirit heart if I get, like, 3 more cents. For now, we'll just focus on the treasure room, I suppose. Hey, there is a fortune teller as well. $3 bill. Occasionally good, occasionally terrible. Usually alright. It's only when you get Ipecac that $3 bill becomes one of those, like, oh my god, I can't believe I picked that up earlier. Okay, well, there is our 2 secret rooms. Okay, just remember the location of that other one. Alright, cool. You know what, fortune teller? Prove to me that you deserve... Yeah, that's well enough. Fine by me. We'll now explode you. for a bomb and a key. That's okay. No skin off my asshole. And we'll open up this secret room. Contains 6 more cents, so we... Whoa, God! And a lot of bombs. So now we can walk back all the way to the shop. It's gonna be a fairly long trip. Pick up that spirit heart. And then we will have 1 extra cent with which to spend on that fortune teller if I wanted to waste a key to do it. Which I might, you know. Feels good. Yeah, you know what? Bomb and 2 keys to open up this golden chest. Better be damn well worth it. That's not bad. It's not great, but, you know, it's not awful. We did get a speed down earlier, so this is fine. We could go to the arcade as well. It's gonna cost us a cent to get in, and we are not gonna have a cent to gamble with after I buy the spirit heart in here. Almost bought the bomb by accident. Suffice it to say, that probably would have been terrible. Now, I'm just hoping. We don't get treasure from the mom boss fight, but we get treasure from the womb part 1. So I'm hoping, against hope, we get a flying item or technology 2. Either of those would, of course, be fantastic options. There's my reflection in action. Why not? You know, we're out of keys. Hey, we got the tick. Yeah, you know what? We'll go with the tick. Because the tick takes off 15%, roughly, of a boss. Ah, that was terrible. 15% of the boss's health when you enter a room, and gives it to you. Probably won't be that useful for me, because I'm dealing mostly in spirit hearts, but even just the 15% drop in health is nice. Probably I don't need any more bombs at this point anyway. So, here we go. Fighting mom, daddy long legs, hopefully we'll be able to- yeah, okay. In the meantime, this fight is going extraordinarily well. Mom is already almost dead. I took a little bit of damage on that fight. But, you know, range upgrade, not really what I was looking for. We do have a compass now, right? We're definitely going utero, maybe utero XL? Yep, okay, well, hopefully we're able to get to the boss as soon as possible. That's all I can say. Otherwise, this could be the final floor for us. Which is obviously something that I would like to avoid happening. But I mean, again, there's a trade-off for this. The good thing is, we may end up skipping, like, basically 2 floors of the womb. Because if I can get to the boss right away, which I'm going to be able to... You have no idea how important that is. Being able to get to the boss right away on a womb XL, like, I'm just skipping by, like, 30 rooms. I'm skipping, like, 2 floors. 2 of the hardest floors in the game, no less. Somehow, you know, the Lord himself took control of my play there and saved me from getting hits. Alright, so we got the Fallen. I guess that's the downside, is that we are going to fight 2 of the hardest bosses in the game. Basically back to back, but Daddy Longlegs is here to back me up. I got Rage anyway. Wow, this is probably the fastest I've ever beaten Fallen. And as a result, we will get no treasure for that, which is garbage, but anyway. Can't complain too hard considering the situation, I guess. Tick and Daddy Longlegs have already done their dirty work. All I have to do is toss in my fire now and then. I think we've got my reflection on this floor, but that's not a big deal. Mom's heart is already like 50% dead. More than 50% dead, perpetually firing now. Really gotta avoid taking damage whenever possible. Not sure if you guys noticed, but I'm pretty sure that was a trip through the womb where I took 0 damage, so, you know, I should get some sort of medal for that, clearly. Now, let's see if we can avoid that through this chain reaction here. Oh, okay, we're still alive. We are going to get to the boss room pretty damn quick. Now this is going to be a little bit hairier. Maybe not. Alright, we're going to play 1 more room. I can't even get to that. What do we got in the mob trap room? Something. Poison touch? It's not that useful. Instead, let's go fight Isaac. It's a possibility. I have such little health. But, you know, between Daddy Longlegs and the candle, I really think it could happen. I need Daddy Longlegs to hit more, though. I mean, we have the tick as well. Is Daddy Longlegs even here anymore? What happened to Daddy Longlegs? That was my go-to. Candle! Candle! Celtic Cross, thank you! Okay, still surviving. Candle. This is big. This is huge! Candle! He's so close to death! Candle. Oh my god, I think we did it. I think we beat the game. Thanks, Daddy Longlegs. Alright, so that is beating the game as Judas. Pretty incredible run so far. Runs recently, anyway. As always, thank you guys for watching. I guess that I'll reload the game on my next episode and see if I've unlocked the Polaroid as an item. If that is the case, let's check our stats quickly. 84 out of 89 secrets, okay. I don't know, we'll see. If I can get the Polaroid, maybe we can find that new boss sooner rather than later. Or there might be a character that I've neglected to remember that I've beaten the game with. But in any case, or I haven't beaten the game with, but you know what I mean. In any case, as always, thank you guys for watching, and I will see you next time.